So, a very good afternoon, very good morning, sorry, very good morning to everybody. I hope all of you can see and hear me clearly. We are back as usual with another session, and all of you know by now that in this session we discuss articles, and various articles are taken up and discussed every day, and it's the ideal preparation for RC or reading comprehension, as all of you know, right? And yesterday, if you remember, we did a passage from Zap 2019. Today, we will pick up an article taken from The Guardian. And before we begin with anything else, before we go ahead with anything else, let me quickly tell you about the schedule on YouTube. The schedule for the entire week is like this. Right. So I hope everybody can understand, right? You can see the schedule very clearly, right? Or as all of you can understand, the schedule is more or less like spread out throughout the week, right? So you all valuable classes, which will definitely help you in your preparation for the exams. Okay, so right, so let's go ahead. Today we will take up an article. You can see this is the source, and why am I showing you the source? To give you a good idea, give you a brief idea as to how the passage is going to be. Like, as you can see, the source is The Guardian, right? And it is basically a review of a restaurant, right? And right at the outset, let me tell you that this passage contains a lot of terms which will look different, which you have never encountered. Try to guess from the context, number one. Number two, the author is very sarcastic, right? He uses, you know, humor, something like, you know, very, he uses humor to attack, right? So he is doing a review of a restaurant, right? And you can see dismal food at eye-popping prices. This entire phrase will tell you the whole thing. Dismal food. What do we mean by dismal? Dismal means something which is bad, shockingly bad, and eye-popping prices. Prices are very high. So let's see. Let me tell you, this is the first line, and right at the outset, as I was telling you, you will see a lot of, you know, terms which are a little bit, you know, which are a little bit off the track, right? So let's see. This is especially because it's written by a British author. Anyway, so I hope everybody can see and hear me clearly. All clear, I think. Okay, so let's see. This is the first slide, so I will take, you know, I'll require everybody to read for some time. And there are many words which I've highlighted, right? Subcommeaning, if I write it down, will take a lot of time. Rather, we will discuss it, right? So let's start with the first word that you see here. Editors do not send the journalists to cover wars because they like misery and carnage. What is carnage? Carnage basically means mass killing, right? So carnage is basically like, very similar to the word massacre, mass killing. Theek hai? Right. Now, so if you read the first few lines, right, you'll understand very easily the author is very much against the restaurant. What is he saying? Editors do not send the journalists to cover wars because they like misery. So journalists ko wahan nahin bhejte because they like misery and carnage. They do so because they want the readers to become aware of what is wrong. The you know they want the readers to become aware of all the misery, all the suffering. Okay, now he is using this, right? Yes, connoisseur, yes. Carnage basically means mass killing. You can also use it for destruction. It can be used in cricket also. Carnage. There is carnage all around. Matlab, Chris Gayle comes and starts hitting everybody for a six. So wo bhi carnage bol sakte hai. But here you are speaking with reference to war, that is the original meaning. Right. So Nikita, dismal. Dismal means something which is so bad, right? Dismal conditions, very bad conditions. Theek hai? So dismal dishes, matlab, you know, dishes which are so bad. Okay, let's see. So why do editors send journalists to cover wars? Not because they like what they see on the war, but because readers should be aware. So he's saying by the same token. So he's saying by the same token, the same analogy, the same reason. What is the meaning of the word albeit? Albeit means although, right? So there is this word Right, albeit is very similar to the word although. Right, very commonly used word, I think. Right, nirav carnage does not mean chaos. Chaos se jada, right? War mein kya hota hai? Killing, misery, right? So carnage is not just chaos, right? War mein kya hota hai? Sirf chaos hota hai? Nahi, mass killing, massacre. Yeah, likha hua na already massacre. Okay, right. So albeit means although. Now, just read the first few lines for the sake of understanding. Now, straight away, yahan se pata chal raha hai, right? I didn't go to the pop-up. What do you mean by this term pop-up? There are many terms here. Pop-up means something which comes up very soon. So he's speaking about this restaurant, right? The pop-up of the Polo Lounge on the rooftop of London's Dorchester's Hotel, because I like watching rich people pay ludicrous prices. Ludicrous means something which is so stupid, right? So stupid and funny. Ludicrous basically means stupidly funny, right? So ludicrous is stupidly funny. Albeit is although, likha hua bhi tha yahan pe, right? And what is the meaning of cack-handed? Cack-handed means food that is prepared without any skill, right? So done without any skill. So cack-handed basically means without skill. So if I use the word cack-handed, it would basically mean without skill. Okay, something that is, so therefore cack-handed food means food that is made or prepared without any skill. Okay, and if you notice, risible and ludicrous are very similar. Ludicrous and, you know, they are very similar. Okay, right. Kushal Kumar, humerus, what is humerus? Humerus kaha hai? What word is it? Hai nahi. Right. Now, and what do you mean by called out? Called out basically means exposed. Okay, right. Ek minute. This paragraph is very difficult, right? I hope all of you understand. Pehle meanings dekh lo. Ludicrous means stupidly funny. Risible is the same, right? And when you call out something, call out means kisi cheez ke asliyat ko dikhana, pardafash karna, to expose. Theek hai? Now, can anybody, so far have you understood? Right. Nikita, yes, the author is talking about a particular restaurant. Kaise? First, look at the first two, three, you know. He says, editors and journalists do not go to wars because they like to see the suffering. So usi tarah he is saying, I did not go to this restaurant because I want to see what is, it's not because I want to see the wrong things happening there, right? I went there because, you know, because I went because some visible hospitality operations need to be called out, right? Called out means exposed. Inka parda fash karne gaya tha. Getting the point? Theek hai? Right. Suman Kumar, risible and ludicrous, ek hi cheez hai. I just told you they are the same. Theek hai? Ludicrous and risible are the same. Theek hai? Dubara parho, what is he saying? He is starting his criticism of the restaurant. Journalists do not go to war because they like to see suffering. In the same way, he did not go to this restaurant to see people being looted by providing bad food. He went there because he wants to expose what is wrong there. Okay, everybody is clear? Okay, now many of you are asking me the meanings of words which I have already told you. Cack-handed, matlab, guess karke dekho, cack-handed food. Kis tarah ka food hoga, guess karo. Right, what kind of a food? He is criticizing this restaurant. Okay, so what kind of food did he get here? Would be very badly prepared. So cack-handed means something that is prepared or done with less skill. Vishnu Vardhan, carnage. Ye to beginning mein bata diya tha. Carnage means war mein jo hume dikhta hai, mass killing, charo taraf logon ka marna. Theek hai? Clear? Right. Now, being positive is all well and good, but that should not mean absolute shockers get the free pass, right? So can you tell me what is the meaning of this overall line? Being positive and is all well and good. He's saying पॉजिटिव होना अच्छी बात है, किसी को नेगेटिव नहीं कहना चाहिए, बट देन व्हाट आर एब्सोल्यूट शॉकर्स, शॉकर्स आर बैड थिंग्स, सो बैड दैट दे आर शॉकिंगली, यू नो राइट, थिंग्स विच आर शॉकिंगली बैड, सो शॉकर्स आर बैड एंड शॉकिंग थिंग्स, राइट? सो इन द वे व्हाट यू सेइंग इज समथिंग लाइक दिस रेस्टोरेंट गेट अ फ्री पास मीन्स नो, इट इज अलाउड टू गो विदाउट एनीबडी चेकिंग इट. ठीक है, नाउ डू यू अंडरस्टैंड द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ? ठीक है, राइट, एवरीबडी इज क्लियर नाउ? सो व्हाट इज द ऑथर डूइंग इन दिस पैराग्राफ, लेट मी रिपीट, राइट? मेनी ऑफ यू माइट नॉट हैव, यू नो, माइट नॉट हैव सीन फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. व्हाट इज सेइंग, ही इज क्रिटिसाइजिंग दिस रेस्टोरेंट, ही इज सेइंग दैट आई डिड नॉट गो देयर टू सी और टू एक्सपीरियंस पीपल बीइंग लूटेड बाय बैडली प्रिपेयर्ड फूड, आई वेंट देयर बिकॉज दे नीड टू बी एक्सपोज्ड, राइट? ये जो गलत कर रहे हैं, राइट, ही वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सपोज इट टू दी पब्लिक, राइट? एंड ही सेज एब्सोल्यूट शॉकर्स शुड नॉट गेट अ फ्री पास, मीनिंग वेरी बैड थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग, उसको ऐसे ही जाने मत दो, राइट? सो इन शॉर्ट ही सेइंग दिस रेस्टोरेंट इज डूइंग समथिंग वेरी रॉन्ग, इट इज वेरी बैड एंड ही वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सपोज इट. सो स्ट्रेट अवे व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम हियर? यू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम हियर दैट द ऑथर इज सेइंग दैट दिस रेस्टोरेंट इज लूटिंग पीपल, फूड इज सो बैड एंड स्टिल दे चार्ज सो सो हाई प्राइसेस. ठीक है, राइट, सो दैट इज व्हाट इज राइट. यस सुमन कुमार, फूड खराब और प्राइस इतना ज्यादा, लोगों को लूट रहे हैं एंड द ऑथर वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सपोज दिस. ठीक है, स्ट्रेट अवे वेरी बैड, यू नो, अटैकिंग वेरी बैडली. ठीक है, ऑल क्लियर आई होप? सो दिस इज बेसिकली व्हाट इज द केस, राइट? सो नाउ यू नो व्हाट इज द मूड ऑफ द ऑथर, ही इज इन अ कॉम्बैटिव अटैकिंग मूड. ठीक है, लेट्स लुक एट द नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट स्टेज, लेट्स लुक एट द नेक्स्ट स्टेज, द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. ठीक है, सो ही इज बेसिकली स्पीकिंग अबाउट अ सर्टन रेस्टोरेंट. ठीक है, राइट, एंड ही इज टेलिंग यू द ओरिजिनल पोलो लाउंज, राइट? ही इज टेलिंग यू अ बिट ऑफ हिस्ट्री, राइट? लेट्स सी. राइट, व्हाट इज दिस इटालियन एक्सेंटेड बिस्ट्रो फूड? व्हाट इज बिस्ट्रो? बिस्ट्रो मीन्स इन एक्सपेंसिव रेस्टोरेंट. बिस्ट्रो क्या होता है? बिस्ट्रो इज बेसिकली इन एक्सपेंसिव रेस्टोरेंट, राइट? सो दिस हैपेंस, बिस्ट्रो इज बेसिकली नथिंग एल्स बट अ रेस्टोरेंट दैट इज, यू नो, दैट इज वेरी, दैट इज नॉट नॉट एक्सपेंसिव. ठीक है, सो आई होप एवरीबडी इज रीडिंग इट, जस्ट रीड इट. ओके, सो लेट्स सी, बिस्ट्रो इज एन इनएक्सपेंसिव रेस्टोरेंट, राइट? सो रेस्टोरेंट्स व्हिच आर इनएक्सपेंसिव, सो ही सेइंग नाउ दिस द ओरिजिनल पोलो लाउंज वाज नेम्ड बिकॉज वेल्दी पोलो प्लेयर्स वंस यूज्ड टू गो इट गो देयर, राइट? नाउ नोबडी गोज फॉर द इटालियन एक्सेंटेड अमेरिकन बिस्ट्रो फूड, सो फूड के बारे में ही इज नॉट गिविंग अ वेरी गुड रिमार्क, राइट? इटालियन, इटालियन एक्सेंटेड मतलब इट्स, इट टेस्ट लाइक, इट इज सिमिलर टू इटालियन एंड बट इट इज अमेरिकन चीप रेस्टोरेंट फूड, राइट? सो व्हाट डज ही मीन बाय दीज लाइंस? लेट्स सी, आई होप एवरीबॉडी इज एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. दे गो देयर टू बी इन अ हॉलीवुड पावर रूम, मतलब दे गो देयर बिकॉज पीपल फ्रॉम हॉलीवुड मोस्टली विजिट देयर, राइट? टू ईट योर श्रिम्प, व्हाट इज श्रिम्प? श्रिम्प इज अ सी फूड, राइट? सो इट्स लाइक, इसको आई डो हिंदी में क्या बोलेंगे आई डोंट नो, श्रिम्प इज लाइक प्रॉन्स जैसा, राइट? सो थोड़ा बिगर टाइप ऑफ प्रॉन्स, राइट? सो पीपल गो देयर टू ईट योर श्रिम्प, राइट? टू टेबल्स डाउन फ्रॉम वूपी गोल्डबर्ग. हु इज दिस वूपी गोल्डबर्ग? गोल्डबर्ग, एनीबडी? सो ही सेइंग पीपल गो देयर नॉट फॉर द फूड बट बिकॉज हॉलीवुड पर्सनैलिटीज गो देयर. हु इज दिस वूपी गोल्डबर्ग? एनीबडी? Have you know, you must have seen, right? Your responses are probably, you know, reaching a little bit late, right? So, shrimp is like हाँ फिश, हाँ प्रॉन, झिंगा तो प्रॉन है राइट, प्रॉन जैसा ही है, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक यू नो इट्स लाइक दैट राइट, थोड़ा सा बिगर होगा विल बी स्लाइटली राइट ओके। सो हु इज दिस वुपी गोलबर्ग? वुपी गोलबर्ग इज अ फेमस अमेरिकन, वेरी फेमस टीवी यू नो टॉक शो का एक यू नो ये है पर्सनालिटी है। सो इज अ ना मोहित एक्टर भी है राइट, वुपी गोल्डबर्ग एक्टर भी है, शी ऑल्सो एक्ट राइट, मतलब सेलिब्रिटी राइट, सो ए हॉलीवुड सेलिब्रिटी इन शॉर्ट ठीक है। सो एंड बेसिकली अ हॉलीवुड सेलिब्रिटी, सो पीपल गो देयर टू सी हॉलीवुड सेलिब्रिटी, सराउंडेड बाय द गोस्ट ऑफ, हु आर दिस पीपल? एस्टर गार्लैंड एंड डाइट्रिच राइट, ये लेट्स से हु आर दिस? सो ही सेज दैट पीपल गो देयर टू मीट और टू यू नो टू गो टू मीट हॉलीवुड पीपल राइट। सो दिस एस्टर गार्लैंड डाइट्रिच, दे आर ऑल हॉलीवुड पर्सनैलिटीज ठीक है राइट, दे आर ऑल। शिवम इज सेइंग वुपी गोल्डबर्ग इज अ रेसलर? नहीं रेसलर नहीं वुपी गोल्डबर्ग, देखो यहाँ देखो, इवन इफ यू डू नॉट नो, मान लो मुझे नहीं भी पता हो, सो यहाँ से मिल रहा है, दे गो देयर टू बी इन हॉलीवुड पावर रूम टू ईट श्रिम्प टू टेबल्स अवे फ्रॉम पीपल लाइक दिस, मतलब पीपल गो देयर टू बी क्लोज टू हॉलीवुड पर्सनैलिटीज ठीक है, हॉलीवुड पर्सनैलिटीज आर ग्राम। सो यस एंकर भी है सुमन कुमार, करेक्ट, एंकर भी है एक्टर भी है राइट, सो शी इज लाइक इन शॉर्ट फेमस बॉलीवुड पर्सनैलिटी। सो हु आर दिस एस्टायर गार्लिन एंड डिट्रिच राइट, सराउंडेड बाय द गोस्ट, इसका मतलब है दे वुड बी डेड पीपल, पीपल हॉलीवुड बी फेमस डेड पीपल फ्रॉम द पास्ट ठीक है। नाउ ऑल क्लियर, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर, दिस लाइन इज गोइंग टू बी इंटरेस्टिंग राइट। नाउ द मेन्यू टेल्स मी दे आर डिलाइटेड टू ब्रिंग अ टेस्ट ऑफ टिनसल टाउन, व्हाट इज टिनसल टाउन? टिनसल टाउन इज यूज टू रेफर टू फिल्म के जो सिटी है राइट, सो इन इंडिया टिनसल टाउन इज बॉलीवुड राइट, इन द यूएस हॉलीवुड इज दी टिनसल टाउन, टिनसल टाउन इज जहां पे फिल्म वगैरह बनते हैं राइट, सो दैट इज बेसिकली द केस। देखो कॉर्निशर, कॉर्निशर सिंह वुपी गोलबर्ग, ओके वुपी गोलबर्ग इज नॉट अ ही, शी है राइट, सो इट मतलब शी है इट नॉट अ ही राइट, एनीवे फॉरगेट दैट राइट, एनीवे ओके। वीएम घोस्ट सिग्निफाइज बेसिकली मींस दीज पीपल आर डेड सेलिब्रिटीज, दीज पीपल आर डेड सेलिब्रिटीज ठीक है, एनीवे सो व्हाट एवर इट इज, मतलब वी शुड नो दैट दे आर पीपल हु आर फ्रॉम हॉलीवुड, एंड घोस्ट क्यों बोलते हैं? बिकॉज दे आर प्रोबेबली डेड पीपल, इवन यू नो पर्सनैलिटीज फ्रॉम द पास्ट ऑल्सो विजिट देयर राइट ओके। सो निकिता यस दिस आर्टिकल इज कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, यस दैट्स एग्जैक्टली वॉट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, दिस स्टाइल ऑफ राइटिंग इज वॉट यू आर वेरी लाइकली टू कम अक्रॉस इन इन दी दिस इज वॉट यू आर लाइकली टू कम अक्रॉस इन दी एग्जाम, बिकॉज फॉरिनर्स जनरली राइट लाइक दिस ठीक है, फॉरिनर्स वुड जनरली राइट लाइक दिस ओके। नाउ लेट्स सी, टिनसल टाउन इज बॉलीवुड हॉलीवुड, सो दे आर डिलाइटेड टू ब्रिंग अ टेस्ट ऑफ टिनसल टाउन टू लंदन कंप्लीट विद पिंक बोगेनविलिया, व्हाट इज पिंक बोगेनविलिया? इट इज इन कोट्स ऑल्सो, व्हाट इज बोगेनविलिया? कैन एनीबडी टेल मी? टिनसल टाउन इज हॉलीवुड, सो दिस रेस्टोरेंट दे आर सेइंग दैट वी विल ब्रिंग अ टेस्ट ऑफ टिनसल टाउन टू लंदन, मतलब बॉलीवुड का टेस्ट दे विल ब्रिंग इट हियर ठीक है। व्हाट इज पिंक बोगेनविलिया? पिंक बोगेनविलिया इसलिए मेंशन्ड है, बोगेनविलिया इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ फ्लावर, इट इज मेंशन्ड हियर बिकॉज दिस पिंक बोगेनविलिया ग्रोज अ लॉट इन हॉलीवुड ठीक है, सो मीनिंग इन लंदन दे आर ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग द एटमोस्फियर ऑफ हॉलीवुड ठीक है। एंड देयर इट इज क्लाइंबिंग द वॉल बिहाइंड मी, मतलब बोगेनविलिया, आई टच इट द बोगेनविलिया इज प्लास्टिक फेक, नाउ सी द सरकैज़म, ही इज टॉन्टिंग, द पर्सन इज टॉन्टिंग राइट, दे वांट टू ब्रिंग यू नो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हॉलीवुड टू लंदन, द बोगेनविलिया इज देयर बट इट इज मेड ऑफ प्लास्टिक, इट इज मेड ऑफ प्लास्टिक ठीक है। नाउ सो आर द टेबल्स द प्लेस मैट्स एंड वेरियस ऑफ माई फेलो डाइनर्स बॉडी पार्ट्स, मतलब एवरीथिंग हियर इज मेड ऑफ प्लास्टिक राइट, एवरीथिंग हियर इज मेड ऑफ प्लास्टिक, So is he praising या is he criticizing? Everything is fake. What is plastic? Fake. ठीक है? All clear? Right. Now, what is the meaning of this last line? Everybody is so fellow diners' body parts. Why does he say that fellow diners' body parts are made of plastic? मतलब क्या है? इसका answer you will find it here. There's anatomy on display tonight that has not moved since 2010. What do you mean by this? Fellow diners, मतलब people in the restaurant who are sitting with him, right? They are also made of plastic. What does it mean? Can you tell me what does it mean? This is what I would like everybody to answer, right? Thoda dhyan se and tell me quickly, right? So, what does he want? What does he mean by this? That the people who are eating with him, they are also made of plastic. Okay, so Vaishnavi, a place where shooting takes place, possibly. So what they're saying is, there's anatomy on display tonight that has not moved since 2010. He is saying there are statues, there are, you know, models made of plastic. Okay, everything is fake. There, it's a statue, everything is fake. So Mohit, correct, Mohit and Nikita, everything there is fake. So this adds to the criticism that he is saying. Okay, clear hai? Chalo, let's look at the next line. Now, this paragraph, he is going to start speaking about the food. So you will come across many terms which will be used to represent food. Exact meaning nahi pata ho, nothing wrong, but try to place it almost like, okay, ye food hai karke. Theek hai? Right. So, you know. So, previous, throughout the two slides, he has been only criticizing the restaurant's ambience, what is happening there, right? Now he is criticizing the food. Theek hai? Yes, Mohit, correct. Ho sakta hai. Hollywood, you know, personalities ke fake statues ho sakta hai. Very possible. So, there are personality, these are Hollywood personalities ke fake statues are actually kept there. Okay, that is what is actually mean. So, things made of plastic. The three diminutive crab cakes for £32 have a rigid shell. The development chefs at Findus would envy and taste. So, what does it mean by here? Development chefs at Findus. Findus would be another restaurant. Development chefs kon hai? The chefs who are still in the learning, you know, stage. Right. And what do you mean by diminutive? Diminutive basically means small. What is a crab cake? Crab cake is a dish made of crabs. Crabs. What is crab? I hope everybody is clear. Crab ko Hindi mein kya bolte hai? Diminutive means small, right? Crab is kekra. Crab is kekra in Hindi. So, he's speaking about the dishes. The dish costs 32 and have a rigid shell. The development chefs at Findus would envy. So, he's saying that they have a shell that young chefs would definitely envy. Theek hai? Right. Next, and taste only lightly of crab as if embarrassed about the star ingredient. What does he mean by this? Matlab, crab cake hai. Lekin taste bahut lightly usme crab. Naam mein crab jarur hai. Lekin taste mein crab bahut kam hai. As if embarrassed about the star ingredient. What do you mean by the star ingredient? Vaishnavi, diminutive does not mean expired. Diminutive means small. Small. Yaha likha hua tha. Diminutive means small. Right. Now, Aniket, why would they envy? Why would they envy? Probably, iska matlab jo hai, what he is criticizing it. It basically means the shell is so rigid. The shell is so rigid that chefs who are not properly trained would like it. Getting the point? So, the shell is so rigid that only improperly trained chefs would like it. So, criticizing. Right. Now, dusra, embarrassed about the star. The star ingredient is the crab. And he's saying that, you know, that the cake does not taste of crab at all. It is almost as if you are feeling shy about the crab. So, in short, he's also criticizing. In short, crab cake mein crab hai hi nahi. Right. And it is almost like it is, so he is criticizing the, you know, criticizing the whole, you know, the dish. Theek hai? Right. Now, Next, they come with a sauce reminiscent of school dinner salad cream, circa 1975. Circa means around. So, next line, if you notice, he's saying, matlab, they come with the sauce. Reminiscent means reminding you of. Theek hai? Everybody knows the meaning of reminiscent, I think. Reminiscent means reminding you of. So, they come with a sauce. Sauce, khane ke saath jo, you know, Western people, they call it sauce, gravy jaisa hota hai, right? So, they come with a sauce that reminds you of school dinner salad cream from the 1975. Matlab, purane zamane ka school time mein jo khate the salad, uska. Theek hai? Right. So, that is what is the case. Reminiscent kya hota hai, Nikita? I just told you right now. Reminiscent means something that reminds you of. Theek hai? Right. Now, next line dekho. A 38 bowl of rigatoni bolognese. Rigatoni bolognese, nothing else but the name of a food. Don't worry, isko define karna, food ka ek item hai. Theek hai? It costs 38 pounds. Look at the price. Hi. Has a grimly sweet and cloying. Grim and cloy. If you notice, cloying is pretending. Theek hai? And grim is serious. Right. Why is he using these terms for this? Grim means serious and cloy means pretending. Theek hai? So, why is he using all these terms? He is using all these terms to say, to criticize. Theek hai? Yash, sarka ka matlab around. Matlab sarka 1975, matlab around 1975. So, the sauce looks like a sauce which you had in 1975. Criticism. Okay, now everybody look up to here. Yahan tak dekho. Why does he say a dish hai, it is grimly sweet and cloying that tastes mostly of tomato, ketchup and profit. What does he mean by this? I'm waiting for your responses. What does he mean by this? Let me explain whether you understand. Let's see. Right. Dekho. He is saying that this bowl of bolognese, right, it is grimly, matlab seriously, in a very sad way, sweet. And cloying means pretending. It tastes of tomato ketchup. So, ye tomato ketchup jaisa taste hai. And profit, matlab, bekar mein paise loot rahe, right. So, this bowl, it costs 38 pounds and it tastes of profit, matlab. It is something which is only for profit. They are doing it only for profit, nothing else. Theek hai? Correct? So, commissioner, correct, talking about, so he is basically, the author, if you notice, everywhere he is sarcastic, he is targeting the restaurant. Right. Grim means serious. Theek hai? Correct? Right. So, too costly. Right. So, that is why he is saying it is too costly. At the same time, the taste is only just ketchup, nothing else. Theek hai? So, the taste is also cheating. So, cheating. Cloying ka meaning yahan se aa raha hai. Now, what about this next line? It's the dish an oligarch who sees his kids only other weekend chooses for them. Who is an oligarch? An oligarch would be a powerful person, almost like a dictator, right? An oligarch would be almost like a dictator, a very powerful person, right? Oligarchy is a form of government where only few people have all the powers. So therefore, who is an oligarch? Oligarch would be a very rich and very powerful don type ka aadmi, dictator type ka aadmi. Theek hai? So he's saying that it's a dish that only a dictator who sees his kids every other weekend chooses for them. How do you see the humor here? Right. The dish, the rigatoni bolognese, right, it is so costly and so bad that it would be bought only by a dictator who buys food for his kids, right. He meets them every other weekend, matlab inke jyada care bhi nahi karta, right. Paise bahut hai uske paas lekin care nahi karta jyada. So that is the meaning. Theek hai? Getting the point? Theek hai? Samajh aa raha hai? So why does he say an oligarch would buy? Because this oligarch who sees his kids, right, every other weekend, that means he does not care too much about them. And second, he has a lot of money. So it's the kind of dish that would be bought by somebody who has a lot of money and who does not care about, achha, theek hai, kha rahe na, mil, khane do. So that kind of thing. Theek hai? Okay. ओलिगोपोली से आता है राइट, ओलिगोपोली इज ऑल्सो देयर, मोनोपोली जैसा ओलिगोपोली इज ऑल्सो देयर, ठीक है राइट. Everybody is understanding it. So if you notice, this author is using typical British humor, and British humor is difficult to understand. ठीक है, यहाँ देखो. According to the menu, these dishes are meant for sharing. I apologize to my companion for doing so. Why is he apologizing? He is saying that these dishes are meant for sharing. I apologize to my companion for doing so. What does it mean? Meaning, it is so bad that I am sorry that I fed it to my companion. So this is basically his humor, right? So all clear, everybody? Right. So this is typical British humor. Right. And look at the sarcasm here. They will be delivered as they are prepared to ensure you receive them at their best. He is quoting the hotel's lines. This is their best. Oh, look at the targeting. He's saying that they're claiming that this is their best, and he's saying this is their best. It is so bad that I would apologize to somebody whom I would give. Right. So look at it. If you notice, he is targeting. He is, you know, matlab, it's in a way he is excoriating the restaurant. Right. Almost like, you know, very badly criticizing. Okay. All clear. Right. Now. लास्ट पैराग्राफ नहीं है, दो पैराग्राफ्स और है, बट लेट्स सी हियर आल्सो यू विल सी. अच्छा, अभी तक क्रिटिसाइजिंग ही किया है. रीड इट फॉर 20 सेकंड्स, देन वी विल आई विल जस्ट गो थ्रू इट. एंड इफ यू नोटिस, दिस इज, इफ यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग लाइक दिस, यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड फॉरेन राइटिंग्स व्हिच आर पब्लिश्ड अब्रॉड वेरी इजी. बट देयर आर पॉजिटिव्स एंड दे मस्ट बी एक्सेंचुएटेड. एक्सेंचुएटेड मीन्स हाईलाइटेड. ठीक है, एक्सेंचुएटेड मीन्स हाईलाइटेड. राइट, ही सेज अभी तक बहुत नेगेटिव कर लिया, चलो पॉजिटिव्स पे भी है, एंड द पॉजिटिव्स मस्ट बी एक्सेंचुएटेड, द पॉजिटिव्स मस्ट बी हाईलाइटेड. बट आई वुड लाइक यू, आफ्टर रीडिंग इट, is it actually positives? Are they actually positives? Just answer this question, right? Just answer this question after you read this. He's saying positives bhi hai, right? Highlight karo, but are they actually positives? Let's see. ठीक है, so accentuated है, मतलब positives को भी highlight करो. So positive क्या है? There's a sweet cloud of chilled strawberry souffle, right? So you know. क्लाउड क्यों बोलता है? बिकॉज इट इज फ्लफी, राइट. इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ चॉकलेट सुफले, तो सबको पता होगा. स्ट्रॉबेरी सुफले बेसिकली इज लाइक अ आइसक्रीम काइंड ऑफ, इट्स अ डेजर्ट बेसिकली, इट्स अ डेजर्ट राइट. यू नो डेजर्ट इज बेसिकली अ काइंड ऑफ अ यू नो स्वीट डिश, ठीक है, विद अ लिटिल कॉम्पोटे एट द बॉटम, नथिंग एल्स बट स्वीट डिशेज, विच इज अ ट्रू डिलाइट, राइट. ही सेज दैट इट इज अ ट्रू डिलाइट, ठीक है, राइट. देन ही सेज इट्स अ 20 pound डिलाइट. नाउ इज इट अ पॉजिटिव? अच्छा है, लेकिन 20 pound का है. सो हियर अगेन इज क्रिटिसाइजिंग दैट जरूरत से ज्यादा, यू नो, जरूरत से ज्यादा एक्सपेंसिव है, राइट. सो डज इट, इज इट अ पॉजिटिव? नो. सो सी द ह्यूमर. देन देर आर द वेटर्स हु आर ऑल फ्रेंडली, रिलैक्स एंड कंप्लीटली ऑन इट. Completely on it, matlab, they are doing their jobs very properly. Does he really mean this, or can you see the irony and the sarcasm here? Right. Is he sarcastic here? Is he sarcastic here? There are the waiters who are all friendly, relaxed, very friendly, very relaxed, and completely on it. Do you know that he is, you know, is he sarcastic here? Yes, expensive employees. Okay. Now, Mohit, employees do not feel safe. They do not just feel safe. Now, notice the sarcasm. They are friendly, relaxed, and completely on it. Right. So, what kind of a, you know, I imagine them on their break with 1,000-yard stares. 1,000-yard stares, matlab, ek dusre se bahut dur, and staring is ghurna. So, are they friendly? They are not. So, when he says friendly, relaxed, and completely on it, he is only being sarcastic. ठीक है। सो दे ऑन अ ब्रेक दे विल बी स्टेइंग 1000 yards फ्रॉम ईच अदर, एक दूसरे को घूर रहे होंगे। सो विल दे बी फ्रेंडली? नो। ब्रूडिंग ऑन अ करियर मूव, ब्रूडिंग इज व्हाट? ब्रूडिंग इज व्हेन यू आर थिंकिंग इन अ कंप्लेनिंग एंड एंग्री मैनर, ठीक है। सो भूमिका, दे आर टू फ्रैंक, डज इट मीन दे आर टू फ्रैंक? नो नो, ही डज नॉट से दे आर टू फ्रैंक। ही सेज दे आर ब्रूडिंग ऑन अ करियर मूव, मतलब दे आर नॉट हैप्पी देयर, राइट? सल्किंग, चेहरे पे एंगर दिख रहा है। एंड दूसरा 1000 yards स्टेयर्स, मतलब व्हेन दे आर ऑन अ ब्रेक दे विल स्टैंड 1000 yards फ्रॉम ईच अदर, एक दूसरे से बहुत दूर, एंड एक दूसरे को घूरेंगे। सो आर दे फ्रेंडली? नो, राइट? एंड लुक एट द लास्ट लास्ट लाइन, राइट? अ लाइफ इन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम वुड सर्टेनली बी लेस सोशली डिवाइजिंग। दिस इज वेर ही इट्स दिस इज अ वेरी क्लेवर राइटर हु इज यूजिंग दिस, अ वेरी क्लेवर राइटर, राइट? नाउ सो ऑन अ ब्रेक दीज वेटर्स दे स्टैंड 1000 yards यू नो फार अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर, एंड दे आर कंप्लेनिंग एंग्रीली एंड प्लानिंग अ करियर मूव। सो आर दे हैप्पी पीपल? नो। आर दे फ्रेंडली? नो, राइट? एंड ही सेज दे आर सो डिवाइडेड, अ लाइफ इन ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम। ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम क्या है? ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम इज लाइक मतलब डॉन टाइप का जो है, ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, मुंबई मुंबई में जो भाई लोग होता है उनका लाइफ, राइट? सो ही सेइंग दे आर मोर सुटेबल, अ लाइफ इन ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम वुड सर्टेनली बी लेस सोशली डिवाइसिव। सो ही सेइंग दैट यू नो दे आर इवन मोर डिवाइडेड देन ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, ठीक है? ऑल क्लियर आई होप, ठीक है, राइट? सो माफिया, सो ही सेइंग दैट द माफिया वुड बी, द माफिया वुड बी मोर फ्रेंडली, द माफिया वुड बी मोर टुगेदर देन देम, ठीक है? सो दैट इज व्हाट ही इज सेइंग, ठीक है, राइट? ऑल क्लियर एवरीबॉडी, राइट? कौशल, ब्रूडिंग क्या होता है? ब्रूडिंग इज व्हेन यू आर एंग्री सैड एंड कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट समथिंग, ठीक है? सो देर इज समबडी ब्रूडिंग इन द कॉर्नर, मतलब किसी चीज से खुश नहीं है और वो ग्रम्बल करके कोने में खड़ा है, चेहरे पे यू नो एंगर लिए हुए, राइट? सो दिस इज व्हाट इज द केस। सो डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? सो दीज आर द आइडियाज, राइट? Now, everybody understood it, I hope. So if you are able to, you know, this is what is very important when you read, you know, writings by skillful writers like this, you should be able to understand what they actually want to say. ठीक है? तो यहाँ कोई positive बिल्कुल नहीं है. Is it a positive finally? Positive बिल्कुल नहीं. इसमें भी he is attacking, right? Commissar, yes, brooding is a sign of being depressed, being unhappy, being angry, complaining, ठीक है? A child brooding in the corner of the room, मतलब क्या है? वो किसी से बात बात नहीं कर रहा, अपने आप यू नो एंगर में है, कंप्लेनिंग में है, एंगर सैडनेस का कंबाइंड मूड, ठीक है, राइट? ओके, सो दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच इज लाइक अ वेरी बैड यू नो क्रिटिसिज्म ऑफ दी, आई एम रियली यू नो आई एम रियली यू नो आई एम रियली एट अ वरी एज टू इसके बाद वो रेस्टोरेंट चला होगा कि नहीं, बंद हो गया कि नहीं, आई डोंट नो, राइट? लास्ट, दिस इज द लास्ट पैराग्राफ दैट वी विल रीड फॉर टुडे, लेट्स रीड दिस, राइट? एंड यू विल नो दैट इवन टुवर्ड्स द एंड ही डज नॉट स्पेयर, मतलब एक सिंगल चीज को बिल्कुल नहीं छोड़ता। Right, his entire, you know, he is summing up the whole thing here. Let's see. A few years ago, my less than positive review of the Parisian gastro palace. What is gastro palace? Gastro is something that is connected to food. Okay, so Parisian gastro palace basically meaning a grand restaurant. Gastro connected to eating and food. So the name of the food was Lisink, right? It was dismissed by the management as rich bashing, right? What is rich bashing? Bashing is attacking or beating. ठीक है? So rich bashing basically means rich लोगों को बेकार में अटैक करना, ठीक है? All clear, right? So what the author is saying here is that you know when a few years ago when he wrote a review of a high-end restaurant, right? The management of the restaurant called it attacking the rich, right? Attacking the rich. Now read the next sentence. Next sentence, that is ultimate. Here it is the restaurant that seems to be bashing the rich. Notice how he's very so humorous. Here it's the restaurant that seems to be bashing the rich. So he is saying here it is the restaurant that is beating or attacking the rich. What is flogging? Flogging means beating them. Dismal matlab very bad, very bad. ठीक है, सो फीडिंग देम डिस्मेल फूड एट इनएक्सप्लिकेबल. इनएक्सप्लिकेबल मीन्स कैन नॉट बी एक्सप्लेन्ड. नोटिस द ह्यूमर, समथिंग विच कांट बी एक्सप्लेन्ड. नो नो कॉमिशर दे एग्री. नो नो द मैनेजमेंट वुड नॉट अग्री. इट्स नॉट अग्रीइंग. ही इज नॉट नॉट अग्रीइंग मैनेजमेंट के. इसका मतलब है, देखो एक चीज है, देखो कॉमिशर यू आर गेटिंग इट रॉन्ग इन द आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड. देखो फर्स्ट लाइन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द ऑफ दैट रेस्टोरेंट व्हेन ही क्रिटिसाइज इट, राइट, द मैनेजमेंट सेड दिस इज नथिंग एल्स बट रिच बैशिंग, मतलब अटैकिंग द रिच, व्हिच मींस दिस रेस्टोरेंट इट केटर्स टू द रिच. ठीक है, ही इज यूजिंग दिस लाइन एंड सेइंग वो तो ठीक था लेकिन इन दिस रेस्टोरेंट, राइट, इट इज द रेस्टोरेंट हु इज बीटिंग लूटिंग द रिच. Flogging them by feeding them very bad food at an inexplicable price, at prices which cannot be explained. ठीक है, flogging is beating. Flogging is beating. So in a way, he is telling you this restaurant is literally beating the rich because they are serving very bad food at very high prices which cannot be explained. Right. Now everybody is clear. Read this last line. At the end, a perky Nikita flogging basically means marna, beating. Flogging and bashing are similar. They are synonyms. Okay, now read the next line. At the end, a perky waiter. Who's perky? Somebody who is very energetic. Okay, energetic, right? Agile. So a perky waiter asks me how it was. And in my gruesome passive aggressive way, he says fine. So now, in my gruesome means something which is very cruel and frightening. Okay. So he says fine. How was it? The waiter asked. The waiter is unnecessarily energetic. Everything is bad, only the waiter here is energetic. So he asks, how is it? And he replies, fine. Is it fine? Right, no. And the waiter replies, amazing. Look at the last line. He's saying, yeah, let's go with that. I have a bill for over £370 for a meal that included a dreadful salad, very bad salad, terrible crab cakes, mediocre pasta, and a grossly overpriced rosé. Rosé is basically a kind of wine. A kind of wine that is pink in color. Right. So everything is bad. He's saying, okay, how was it? And he replies in a sarcastic manner, it is fine. And the waiter replies, amazing. And he says, what can be more amazing than food which is very bad for £370? Right. If that isn't amazing, I really do not know what it is. So he's almost like very badly criticizing. ठीक है, राइट. सो दिस रोसे इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ वाइन वुड बी पिंक इन कलर. ठीक है, राइट. आई होप वी हैव डन इट इनफ, राइट. देर आर टू मोर स्लाइड्स बट दिस आई विल स्किप, राइट. सो इसको रहने दो, दिस विल बी टू डिफिकल्ट. आई होप एवरीबडी अंडरस्टूड, राइट. सो आई वुड लाइक एवरीबडी टू बी एक्सपोज टू सच स्टफ एवरी डे. ठीक है, राइट. सो दैट्स व्हाट वी विल ट्राई टू रीड एवरी डे. एंड इफ यू आर केपेबल ऑफ इंटरप्रेटिंग सच पैसेजेस, राइट, कैट में जो पैसेजेस आएगा दे विल बिकम अ लिटिल बिट इजियर. ठीक है, राइट. एवरीबॉडी इज क्लियर, राइट. नाउ सम इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट यू नो व्हिच माइट बी यूजफुल टू यू बिफोर वी एंड द डे, राइट. सो एवरीबॉडी इज क्लियर आई होप. सो यू कैन क्विकली लुक एट द इंफॉर्मेशन. द बैचेस व्हिच आर लॉन्च्ड ऑन 13th ऑफ ऑगस्ट Source, this is the Guardian. In the beginning, remember I showed you the source. The source is the Guardian newspaper. Beginning में दिखाया था मैंने, ठीक है, right? So it's the review of an of a you know of a restaurant, and it is written in a very sarcastic way. Okay, Cornisher, you can easily find ये passages. Guardian में जाओ, you can I if you want I'll show you the source again. Source is here. Everybody can see the source. First page में ही you can see the source very easily. This is the source. Right. You can easily see. August 15th का है article. ठीक है. So we will end it here. Information, these are information about batches which you already know, I think, right? So there are CAT 2022 batches, there are batches for other exams also, right? And you can see the teachers who take your classes, and subscription is like this. And those of you who are preparing for Maharashtra CET, there is this live mock, right, which will be live from 21st to 23rd. It will be for logical reasoning in AR. Take it and you know measure your performance in Maharashtra CET. Right. So we will end it here. Thank you everybody. Do not forget to like the session, and I will meet you again tomorrow with such articles. So let's do this every day so that you do not lose out on exposure to difficult and you know interesting articles. Right. So this is nothing else but preparation for what might come in the exam. Right. So V is saying Hindu se CAT mein expected nahi dekho. Everybody, before I end, let me tell you one more thing. When it comes to the exam CAT, most of the articles are taken from foreign publications, right? Indian publications se zyada tar nahi likhte, right? They take it 99.9%.